So the finalist in Memphis this year for Vergler, lost to Rakovic after beating Heather Watts earlier on in the tournament. She's qualified, made second round in both Indian Wells and Miami. Big tournaments, of course. Lost to Petrova and Flipkins. Joe's already talked about the semis in Charleston, but also third round at the French. That was her best major. She beat Heather Watson again first round. Then Kaya Kanepi, the big hitting Estonian, before losing to Kirilenko. 6-5, 7 in the breaker. So that was a tight match to lose for a fourth round at a major championships. She's only finished in the top 100 once in her career, and that was 4 years ago, Vergler, 76th in the world. So she's going to do that this year and have a career best year, no doubt about that. She's currently ranked 58, but she was top 50 in August this year. Anna Ivanovic, I'm sure you know all there is to know about this woman. 11 titles from 15 finals. The French Open, of course, 08, beating Safina, a number one in the world straight after that for 12 weeks. The struggle to recreate that sort of form and ranking ever since. A couple of years ago, down at 60-odd in the world. It's looking pretty bleak. So she's done very well, actually, to get back into the top 20. And not that long ago, close to the top 10 again.
Yeah, tantalisingly close to the top 10, but not quite. And when you've been number one in the world and won a Grand Slam, you know, those are the places where you're looking to be. So still a little bit frustrating, you feel, for Anna. Some of the tennis she plays is definitely top 10 or better. But stringing it together match after match.
And as you mentioned, Joe, she served very well yesterday, but she served really well all week. She's only served one double fault against Vikmaier and Schiavone in each of those matches. She had four against Sibulkova. She had a bit of a blip on the serve against Sibulkova in one particular service game. But apart from that, it's looked really good. And maybe that's linked to the sort of the more consistent stuff we're seeing off the ground, too.
Yeah, I know. It's looked really solid. I think so. She's relying on it. It's nice for her to play indoors because there's nothing to interfere with the ball toss at all. So time after time, she can get it in a better place. And then you find so much more rhythm each time. And that's where you get your confidence from. Those results you're talking about. Sibulkova, of course, she went three love down in the second.
Und gegen Dominika
Cipulcova and then charged back.
Ich freue mich. Wir alle freuen uns auf die Serbin Anna Ivanovic.
Sixth visit, fourth semi. Looking for a third final. Third semi of the year, but it would be a first final and the first, remember, since she won Bali in 2011. Big match for the pair of Tamara Vrovec of Croatia in the chair. Confident winning the toss and choosing to serve Vergler. Your predictions, Joe?
I just think Ivanovic is in a good place with herself at the moment and her tennis, and she seems to be going through the draw pretty easily. So I think she's going to win in two, but an inspired Vogelet, well, you don't know. She could have a go and, you know, maybe sneak a set. I'm not sure if she's got it in her to win, but we've seen some surprising things in tennis.
Second ladies semi-final in the Generali ladies Linz for the right to play Angelique Kerber, top seed in the final tomorrow. Anna Ivanovic, two times a former champion, against a debut semi-finalist Stephanie Vergler, who begins. Trademark working straight away. We'll look to boss this from the get-go. Mm-hmm.
37. Love that.
Has been pointed out by Banana Sharapova. It's not identical, the outfits, but similar enough. Well played. Did I take the point?
Yeah, but you'd think they'd have two or three different colours, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
Just slightly different.
I'd ban it.
Ooh, that's big talk from you, Chris. What if it was the favourite outfit of both of them?
Spin a coin.
Ooh, that's harsh.
Higher ranked player chooses. Earn it. Well played. Ivanovic thought it was out. She felt aggrieved a number of times yesterday with the lack of calling.
Not sure. That took a funny bounce, I thought.
I thought it hit the line, I must say.
And anyway, Ivanovic should have won the point earlier. She very early on had Virgil out to a corner. Yeah. That was in, wasn't it?
Definitely caught the line, yeah. So good hold for Virgil. Gets her nose in front.
Yeah, very good steadying game. Make her feel very good. But, of course, you know, having not played before, just work out a few things about your opponent, what's working, what's not. I think if Ivanovic fires a hard one into the Virgil backhand side and she stretches, she's going to be under a lot of pressure. I wouldn't be surprised if Anna didn't come into the net quite often in this match. Take your luck when it's there.
She hung in the point all the way through it.
Yeah, that one she was fighting against, and well, quite honestly, that could have gone anywhere.
Yeah, and it shows you the pace Virgil hits at.
Mm.
This is not a quick call. And Ivanovic putting the Swiss under pressure. Again, still lives there, northern Switzerland, close to the German border.
Oh.
Ivanovic, born in Belgrade, his home's in Basel, Marbella, Belgrade. Brilliant. Love game for Ivanovic to open her account with.
Yeah, I think she's going to be watching carefully to see what her shots are doing so she can sneak in like this. It was a very good volley from below the height of the net.
Only 23 years old, Joe Vergler. Top 25 player?
Well, I think she's got the big serve. I think she's got big shots for that. Whether she can be consistent enough.
Terrific footwork, too.
Yeah. I mean, she gets a little caught out wide on the backhand, but, you know, I'm being picky. And I've, you know, watched her in Charleston. I was thinking, right, her ranking's just going to absolutely go wild now, and I'm wondering why it isn't a little bit higher.
She's made 30% of her entire career prize money this year, Vergler. She's close to $1 million now and made nearly $350,000 2013. It's been a great year for her, breakthrough year. In terms of belief that she can live with the best. Having beaten Wozniacki, top 10 player too. It's all looking good. And 2-1 first set she leads. 1-2, Ivanovic first set. It's about 10 minutes.
It really is a very well hit shot. And Ivanovic struggling to get anywhere near the return.
Ball toss way left. Normally we see it struggling to the right. Using a lot more of the kicker serve, especially under the guidance of Nigel Sears, something he talked about in commentary recently. In the match against Wickmar.
These lines people had better be ready. Number of shots already landing on or near the lines. Ooh.
Serve again, serving her well. Miss it, return, and then dispatched with this wonderful forehand. Seven aces against Sibulkova yesterday. That's how good the serve has been.
Well, actually, I thought Anna sold her a dummy there because she threw the ball out to the right again. It did look like she was going down the tee, and Vergler moved across.
Good start to this semi-final. After the one-sided first.
13.
Ivanovic at her best, the kind of flowing tennis. The timing.
Where would you rank her forehand in the world?
Well, it's up there amongst the best when it's on and like this.
Backhand's not too shabby either off a short serve.
Something she was doing very well yesterday, was taking that cross-court one on.
Only lost 1 point so far behind her first serve, Vergler, but 2 from 6 now behind the second. An issue. It puts so much pressure then on your first serve when your second serve's getting hammered. First break point of the match. Chance to see sometimes you hit the backhand cross court return, ball then comes back quite slowly back cross court. Why not then use the forehand? Does that quite a lot make the error off the second backhand in a row? Because the forehand's so good when she moves to her left anyway. Good play.
I think you have to make a very quick decision, don't you? Nifty footwork behind it. And if you don't, you have to hit the backhand.
Yeah.
But it's always difficult, I think, you know, to hit that backhand down the line suddenly. You think you should hit an outright winner.
Yeah. Well, she gave it a go. I think Ivanovic wants to have a chat with coach. She certainly pointed at it. Vergler saves the break point. First mini battle to the Swiss. 3-2 the lead. Dragana and Miroslav, Anna's parents. Coach did come on, or hitting partner, Nemanja Kontich, for a chat. He did most of the talking too. Ivanovic 2-3 first set. I think Vergler's got her full respect in this first meeting already.
Yes, it's just that Vergler's hitting it well and so consistently so far. I mean, she's having a great time out on court.
Well, you said she might need to do a bit of that today.
Yeah, I wondered why she hasn't taken more out of the air, actually, with the drive volleys. But that's the one, the stretching backhand from Vergler is never going to go anywhere.
Is that in? Call from the chair. Did it have anything to do with Ivanovic's reaction?
I
Getting that backhand error down the line. I mean, backhand by comparison to the forehand is the support cast, Ivanovic, isn't it? As you say, that's an ambitious choice. When you then look at that.
Yeah. What a difference.
I used to love, and I used to work with players, used to get them the blank sheet of paper and just write down all the shots. Say, what's their role in your game? Surprised me how often there's a bit of a blank look on the faces before the pen got used. Good hold that. 3-all first set.
I think sometimes you just take it for granted, don't you? You don't really think about it. And it is when it stares you there, black and white. Oh, you know, maybe I've got to do more with this or use that one in a better way.
Radvanska's sort of brought this knee bend shot to the game, hasn't she, really?
It's a way of getting out of trouble if you haven't moved your feet, honestly.
Yes, because you just go straight down, you mean?
Yeah, which is what Radvanska says. That's why she perfected it, because she was lazy.
Did she say that?
Yeah. Panic then with Ivanovic coming in as her.
She looks like a believer, doesn't she, Virgil? She looks like she feels she belongs in this class, in this semi-final of an international event.
Yeah.
It's half the battle, that little footstep. And tap of that back foot. So individual, this serve. They all are, but this one particularly. Sure to do it, isn't it? Six double faults against Zakopalova. That was her most costly. Just one less against Knapp. And two against Sloane Stephens yesterday in 2¾ hours. Good response. Those double faults and aces so often. Side by side. Nudging the scoreboard along nicely. The Swiss number one leads 4-3 against the former world number one. Quite a question being asked of Ivanovic here, serving with new balls, 3-4 first set, on serve, no breaks yet.
So Ivanovic just has to be a little careful, doesn't she? Her opponent is playing wonderfully well and it seems to be sort of very composed about it, very within herself.
Ivanovic has only lost 1 point behind her first serve, but 4 from 7 behind the second. From 8, rather. That's probably why the double faults are there. Similar game plan, really, behind serve. in terms of the percentages. That's way long. First break points for Vergla.
Try and keep the pressure on Ivanovic. Starting with the serve.
Will she go for the ace out wide again? Nope. Pretty much an ace down the tee. Good switch up. Quickly back to deuce.
Solid serving. Oof. Yeah, it's getting to her a bit.
Looks so calm. She doesn't look, well, she looks a little tired facially, but movement-wise and everything else, she looks fine.
Yeah.
After 7 hours, 21 minutes to the semis. Play Monday, Thursday, Friday, Vergla. That would have helped. Oop. Those miss hits are horrible. Because you can, I mean, you know they're gonna, it's going to bounce funny, but that was weird, that bounce.
It was all over the place. Strange shot. Oh, did well to get it back. That really put her off.
Well, Vergla can't believe one wasn't called out. We've seen that a lot this week, Joe. They've lost a lot of confidence.
Yeah, well, it just shows you, I mean, you can't rely on a challenge. You can't challenge anything. And you're going to question everything.
Yeah. As you said the other day, it's like the old days.
Yeah.
You get a bit of aggro with the umpire and it's a bit of excitement.
It does.
Would you prefer to go back to that, or are you happy with Hawkeye?
No, I think Hawkeye's pretty fair overall. But, you know, when you don't have it on every court, it's a little difficult. It's only Indian Wells, isn't it?
Yeah, literally.
You know, on the clay courts, of course, you look at the mark, so that's very different.
Played. What do you think of Annabelle's point about why is there a limit of challenges? 3%, one extra for a tie break. It should be limitless. Like clay, you can ask an umpire to have a look as many times as you like. Yeah,
that is a good point.
Just to find out the truth, as she calls it.
Can you imagine Roger Federer, though? Limitless challenges. He hates them anyway.
He does, doesn't he? Yeah. See Federer challenge, he's like, rack it up in the air, doesn't look at the umpire.
He needed that serve, getting herself in a bit of trouble here.
She's used that. They've both used that serve well already, haven't they? It's a popular serve. So Vergler's got to do an Ivanovic and hold from 15-40. Very good.
Yeah, perfect serve, isn't it? Just coming off the service line. Standing.
Backhand very solid in that point from Ivanovic, didn't go for too much and gets rewarded. It's the first break in this semi-final. Ivanovic will serve for the opening set at 5-4. Over half an hour, Ivanovic having just broken for the first time, serving for the opening set at 5-4. Second semi-final at Linz. Kerber comfortably through to the final, 2 and love against Suarez Navarro in the first semi-final.
Don't want to jinx Anna, but I think she's coped pretty well with an opponent who's come after her, and there's been moments, you know, she's had to save break points. It's not over yet this set, but overall she served well.
Squeeze now, Joe.
Yeah, I'm sure that was going to be a double.
Three set points now. Tops and tails the set with a love service game, Ivanovic. Not without its battles, but she's halfway to the final. 6-4 in 34 minutes. Sorry, we're a little late back. Ace out wide on the first point for Vergler, an unreturnable out wide to the backhand on the second point after a pretty stern chat with her coach Ivo Werner at the sit-down. The Swiss number one starting this set very positively. I knew I was leading down the wrong path there. Second double. That's so good. It's just such great ball striking.
And then, you know, moving around the backhand side yet again. That one was deep enough, but this really was searching it out. Oh, she rather enjoyed that one, Anna.
30-14. Well, 30 love to break point.
Kept her cool, Vergler.
I'm
easy to get panicked and you go a set down and you've played well.
She's lost the last three games in a row. Robbed. 4-3 up first set. It looked very tight.
4-3, two break points. Yeah.
Play. Good defence, Milanovic, but Vergler very strong.
It's a good leap for the smash. You just got to sort of hang there and then get the racket head to come up and over.
Third chance to keep building momentum.
Again, the use of the forehand. Great belief in it.
It's like she's testing the water with this little footstep, isn't it? There, and it goes back again.
Yeah. No way back.
She's enjoying this, isn't
yeah,
she?
Yeah, of course, she should be. Einstein, yes. Just flicks that over there. Couldn't it be more perfect?
So good again, just moving to the left. The forehand becomes magical. Just look at this, little shimmy to the left. She's got both ways the choice, but chooses that. So you can disguise it to the last second, can't you?
Yeah.
Well, it was after the break and has now won five games, four games in a row.
Getting excited there, Chris.
I was never good at maths.
But it does feel like more, actually. The way she's come back from, as you were just saying, 4-3 down, two break points, to win the next four games. She's really got her head together and got on with it, and she's going about the match in the right way. She's hurrying Vergler. Now you feel off that forehand side. A lot of winners. Thought she might come to net just a little bit more.
Vergler's not playing badly, it's just Ivanovic, as we've said all week, is in a very good place at the moment. Maybe just the fact she's done so well here.
Mm.
She feels that she's going to win irrespective of what happens.
Yeah. Well, you get that at tournaments, you just feel so at home.
Plenty thought that, was it?
Mutterings, yes. God, good, that nearly hit the baseline.
It's great that she can
yes.
laugh. Love that.
Well, I was just thinking, what a good way to put the second serve in as well. Well, she knows she should have caught the ball toss.
Hope it doesn't put her off, because it was that wayward. It certainly unsettled the rhythm. Not smiling now.
No. Really not. 30 love is all going in the right direction and she's just thrown herself.
Broke back point.
Spiel.
4 points in a row and quickly. Bergler back in touch. Back on the scoreboard.
Well, what a change. It's like you suddenly jolt yourself out of a lovely sort of smooth, focused and feeling good kind of mood, and it's suddenly boom, you go off track and then you start overthinking. It's incredible the difference. That came off beautifully. Oh. That was going long. Just jumped off the line.
Going on from Kerber and coach. Oh, this match is swinging. Bergler just plugging away. Barnovic getting a little grumpy. 2 games in a row for the Swiss, and she leads 2-1 second set. Another chat with Ivanovic and Nemanja Kontić at that sit-down. Just needs to stabilise here with a hold, the Serb. It's just starting to fall apart a little. Fourth double.
All stemmed from that awful ball toss and the serve that nearly hit the baseline and the little laugh about it. But since then,
maybe the laugh now is a bad thing because it sort of totally broke her concentration almost. But I thought it was a good way of dismissing it initially.
Yeah, me too.
Да.
But she had a good little run going, and Vergele really wasn't staying with her, and then suddenly it's all changed back, and Ivanovic needs more of that.
Super. Boy, oh boy, that is good. And I guess that's why she's ranked 16 in the world, Joe.
Yep.
Because when you've got your opponent down like that, you're building momentum, and you've got set and a break one love, 30 love up. You know, that's the time to get the shovel out and dig them a bit deeper, isn't it?
Yeah. Yes, it is.
Which obviously she did, winning the French and getting to number one in the world. She knows she can do it and has done it. It's a good hold to re-establish.
Yes, sort of got a more balanced feel about it again this match. And it was very tight in that first set. I thought Ivanovic had to play pretty well to get out of it 6-4.
Huge win in Shanghai for Del Potro. He's beaten Nadal in straight sets.
Mm-hmm.
Plays Djokovic in the final.
What a result.
Nadal, number one in the world again, of course.
15.
Third double. Expression hardly ever changes. She looks like a real thinker. That little foot tap. You ever seen a serve like that, or a server do that? A little step.
Mm.
There. There.
Nice and composed, actually, Vergele, even after going to break down at the beginning of this set.
Stays ahead with a hold, 3-2 Vergele. In this second set. The first semi-final would have finished by now. Still plenty left in this one. Ivanovic set up, 2-3 down, second set. Well, they drag themselves over, they always do on this net this week.
15.
Made it.
She has played that shot so well today. And you really think, you know, if you don't do enough with this, you're in big trouble because it's too much of an open court. So it literally has to go on the line.
Wow, what a game that was. Quickly levels, a love game. A third.
It's some new balls coming, so I think Vergla better watch out for Ivanovic. She's going to really lean on some of these returns.
She's only getting half her first serves in, isn't she, Vergla? And only winning half behind a second, so it's important still. Tube had to be the shot, didn't it?
It did, really. If you're that close to someone and they're going to stand there at the net, you know, don't be too clever about it. Yeah, I had a choice of where to go on that one for sure. A miss hit from Vergla.
Boy, oh boy. Well, 3-2 Vergla at the sit down. Seven very quick points later. It's a completely different feel about it. Yeah. Three more break points. No smile this time.
15-14. All that running for nothing.
This would be a great game to hold. It's a wonderful feeling when you hold with just one break point in it, but a love 40 hold, there's nothing much better than that. Anna makes sure. Brilliant use of the forehand. Demanded that. And won. Set 4-3 now, Ivanovic. Vergla's turn to have coach on. Time running out. Bit of inspiration from Ivanovic last couple of games. Second time, second set with the break. Leads a set 4-3 now.
Too good. That's a good point for Vergla as well. I really think Vergla has played ever so well consistently, and it's a good job that Ivanovic has sort of pulled herself up, raised her standard. Forced really to take on maybe just a little bit more than she can manage. This is when she has to try and really stretch herself.
One love with a break, 30 love at the start of this set. No mistake this time. It's 11 out of the last 13 points for Ivanovic. Make that 12 from 14. Two love games in a row on serve. Racing to the final.
Yeah, it's like she's just sort of gone up into fifth gear at least. And is motoring away.
Lofty.
Still a great attitude from Stephanie Vergela. Head down, getting on with it, try and win this game, and let's see if she can go after the next. Well, that's good, Anna giving it.
She'll have to serve it out. Ivanovic at a set and 5-4. So the moment of truth, a little caption serving for the match can play some havoc with the mind.
Yeah, it's exciting because you think, oh, I'm nearly there, but you've got to keep composed and focused and just do what you've been doing.
Hasn't been in a final of a tour event since the end of 11, Ivanovic, but serving for one now at a set in 5-4. That is a nervy start.
Well, that look said it all over to her supporters.
When you get out of the habit of finishing off. Very close.
I think Vergela's just having a little look over. Everyone wondering if it was going to be called out.
It looked good, didn't it?
Yep.
Very positive, didn't doubt herself for a second.
Yeah, it was a really good stance. She was very strong off the right leg into those forehands. She'd prepared so early, kept her feet going.
This is really good from Love 30. This is Ivanovic of old. Match point. She's done it. Taken the best part of 2 years, but Anna Ivanovic has found herself a way through to another tour final. 16th in all. Great effort from Vergler. It's been a wonderful tournament, but it's Ivanovic who will face Kerber tomorrow.
You know, and generally I thought she handled that very well, because she did get a little bit jittery in that last game, but then composed herself beautifully to win it.
And remember the name, Stephanie Vergler. Terrific week. It's her best year on tour. Let's wish her well for the rest of this year and look forward to seeing her again into next.
Yes, very well played. So ranking surely has got to go up with performances like this.
You've never faced Stephanie before and you looked fairly comfortable out there. Maybe got a little bit nervous towards the end?
Well, I was a bit awkward in the beginning because, you know, she played really well, and it's always tough playing someone for the first time. But, you know, I'm really happy I managed to stay calm towards the end of the first set, close it out, and then see him in the second. It was a very tough match.
Did you realize that you just won your 20th match here at the Generali Ladies Linz? Why do you think you're always performing so well here?
I like it here a lot, and the crowd is amazing, and I really enjoy, and Sandra and Peter are doing a great job with the tournament, and it's always fun, you know, and to have my family here too.
We have a dream final coming up tomorrow, you against Angie Kerber. What are your thoughts about that? It must be exciting. Maybe a first title of the year as well for you.
Yeah, well, on Sunday morning, no one really thought that. She wasn't even in the draw. But it's definitely a great match. And, you know, we played recently in Tokyo, and we played a few times this year, so I look forward to that. And it's definitely going to be a great matchup, so I hope everyone can enjoy some fun tennis.
Once again, can you show me or tell me what's Kaman in your language? Because you say it all the time. Come on, give us one more time the Kaman.
I did.
That's it. Thank you.
Well, it'll be a first title for either Ivanovic or Kerber tomorrow for this year. Who's your money on, Joe?
My money's on Kerber.
Who did win in Tokyo.
Yes. But a little reference there from Anna, not happy with the way the draw was done here, and Kerber getting in.
Could be feisty then.
I think it could be, yeah. I think Anna just is playing supremely well. Hopefully both will play well. It'll be super final.
It's great to see her back to being in a final and playing some really good tennis again, the former world number one. WTA must be delighted.